Good morning and welcome to Rye Hill Baptist Church for Sunday morning, November 6th, 2016. This morning's message brought to us by Brother Steve Stewart is entitled, Here Comes the Great I Am.
If you have your Bibles today, I invite you to turn to Matthew chapter 14. Matthew chapter 14, going to be speaking on this subject today. Here comes the great I am. Before we read this passage, I was sitting in my office the other day and I was just thinking about the moments God came to different individuals. And I began to think back in the book of Genesis where it says that God came to Adam and Eve in the cool of the day. Now, can you imagine what it was like when there was no sin yet? And just imagine what it was like when God came in the cool of the day to walk with man. Can you imagine the fellowship and the relationship that God and man had? And I'm reminded, as I began to read that passage in Genesis about what happened, I'm reminded that man, being Adam, who was the responsible one, plunged the entire human race into sin. And you remember, after they sinned against God by eating of a tree they should not have been eating of, you remember what they did? They realized for the first time in their life they were naked. And so what they did, they hid themselves. And here was the idea. They tried, or they thought they could hide themselves and hide their sin from God. Folks, we know that we can't do that, right? And here's what I love about God. God would come to them in the cool of the day, even in the midst when there was no sin. But after sin began in the human race, God still came. Do you realize it says there in Genesis that God still came in the cool of the day, and here's what He did. He clothed them Himself. You remember He sacrificed and He took the coverings from that animal and He clothed Adam and Eve. I'm reminded of what happened on Mount Carmel when Elijah, that great prophet of God, stood there amidst all of the prophets of Baal, and they were going to have this contest, and I'll never forget what Elijah said. Elijah, he told the prophets of Baal, he said, now why don't you just go ahead and I'm going to let you go first and I want you to cry out to your God and I want you to build this altar and after you build this altar, you put the bull upon that altar and you call on your gods. And may the God who hears bring fire down from heaven. And you remember that the people of the prophets of Baal and all of their people, they went to work, they built that altar, they put on the sacrifice, and they cried, and it came upon noontime, and they were still crying out to their God, and the Bible says there was no voice that came from their God. And you see, they continued that all day. And a matter of fact, Elijah, in a sarcastic way, I can sense as I read that story, He said, you're going to have to call upon your God a little bit louder. He's not listening, or he may be out of the country somewhere, or he's asleep. He's not hearing what you're saying. And so as they began to, as their custom was, you can read it there in 1 Kings, their custom was to cut themselves and to make themselves bleed as if that was calling out to their God. But all in all, they heard no voice. And then Elijah said, it's my turn. And Elijah repaired the altar there, and he had a bull. He got a bull and prepared the bull, and he was going to put that bull upon the sacrifice and sacrifice that animal. And he had them dig some trenches around, you know, put the seed in. And he also said, why don't you cover it with water? And he had them do that three different times. And so he just drenched that altar. And then he did this. He cried out to God. And folks, it didn't take all day. It didn't take even a minute. The God of heaven who comes to His people, answered by fire, consumed up that sacrifice. God came, the great I am. Can you imagine what it was like when Lazarus was sick and his sisters, Mary and Martha, both cried out to, or sent word to Jesus and said, hey, your friend, our brother, he's sick and we're fearing he's going to die. And of course, Jesus knows all this. And Jesus tarried, as the Bible says. 4 days. And you remember when he was coming over the horizon, one of the sisters went out to meet him and said, now, if you'd have been here, and can you imagine, doing that to the Lord? If you'd have been here, our brother would not have died. But aren't you glad, even in the midst of any storm, it doesn't matter if God's one day late or 2 days late, 3 days late, 4 days late, He still comes. And He came. And you know what Martha said? Now, Lord, you know my brother stinks. He's been in there 4 days. Now, folks, it's amazing to me that we can think that God can raise somebody from the dead, but He can't take care of the stink. Folks, I promise you, when He comes to you as the great I am, it doesn't matter what this world has thrown on you, the filth, the smell, whatever it is, He can take care of it. Amen? And so as you have your Bibles open to Matthew chapter 14, we're going to see an account here of the Lord Jesus Christ coming to His people. And we're going to see three different things in this passage today. Number one, you're going to see that He prays for us. Secondly, you're going to see that He comes to us. And number three, you're going to see that He ministers to us. Oh, listen, that's the kind of Jesus that we have. Amen? Well, let's read, beginning in verse 22 of Matthew chapter 14. It says, immediately, now Jesus has just fed the 5,000. He has sent the multitudes away. Immediately, Jesus made His disciples get into the boat and go before Him to the other side while He sent the multitudes away. And when He had sent the multitudes away, He went up on the mountain by Himself to pray. Now, when the evening came, He was alone there. But the boat was now in the middle of the sea, tossed by the waves, for the wind was contrary. Now in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went to them walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw Him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, "It is a ghost," and they cried out for fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Be of good cheer, it is I, do not be afraid." And Peter answered Him and said, "Lord, if it is You, command me to come to You on the water." So He said, "Come." And when Peter had come down out of the boat, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But when he saw that the wind was boisterous, he was afraid, and beginning to sink, he cried out, saying, "Lord, save me." And immediately Jesus stretched out His hand and caught him and said to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" And when they got into the boat, the wind ceased. Here comes the great I Am. I remember that old character I remember as a kid named Charlie Brown. You remember Charlie Brown? Charlie Brown was on the seashore, and he decided he was going to build him a masterpiece. So he built him this beautiful sandcastle. And he began, as he was building that and as he was finishing his work, he stepped back and he looked at what he had just done, and he loved it, and he was just admiring his work. And it wasn't long until the winds picked up just a little bit and the tide changed a little bit and the waves began to crash against the shore, and all of a sudden, Charlie Brown's sandcastle was swept away by the waves. As he was still standing there in that same spot, moments before looking and admiring his sandcastle, he looks at that leveled off sand that used to be his sandcastle, and he said this, "There's got to be a lesson in this somewhere." And you know what, folks? In this scripture here today, there are several lessons for us as we find our lives being battered and find the waves of life coming against us and wiping us out, it seems like. But all in all, we find that Jesus Christ is going to come to our rescue. Amen? Well, what do the storms of life reveal to us? All of us are either in a storm, or we've just got out of the storm, or we're going to be in a storm at some point. So what do they reveal to us? Well, they reveal to us the nature of our faith. In other words, the storms reveal who I am. And I want to be a